on an organisation's core activities and values, its reasons for committing to carbon management will vary, as will the initiatives it chooses to undertake. For a place of education and research, such as the University of Queensland, innovation and global leadership are central drivers behind its carbon management strategy. Andrew Wilson is the Manager of Energy and Sustainability at the University of Queensland. In this video, he shares some of the ways UQ is leading in this field.
So the University of Queensland is one of Australia's largest universities and ranked within the top 50 universities in the world. We've got over 60,000 staff and students and over 500 buildings across our campuses and sites. As an organisation as large as UQ, we're a really significant consumer of electricity and natural gas for our buildings and activities. In fact, over 97% of our greenhouse gas footprint is comprised of energy usage. So this energy usage, as well as being a really significant operational cost, gives us the opportunity to demonstrate our leadership in this area, to show others how they can reduce their carbon footprint in an economical and efficient manner, and to inspire and teach others how to do this. This links in really well with many of the research and teaching programs that the university has. In fact, many of our projects, when we undertake them, are framed as living laboratories. That is, that not only do they reduce our carbon footprint and our energy usage, but they're also able to be used as teaching resources for our student and staff. Electricity is by far our biggest source of energy usage at the University of Queensland. We use around about 146 million kilowatt hours of electricity every year from the grid. To give some context to that, that's equivalent to around about 25,000 average Queensland households, and it equates to a spend on electricity of around about $22 million per year. UQ has a really comprehensive energy management program, and this focuses across all areas of our energy usage. So it includes things like efficiency of the air conditioning systems within buildings, the efficiency of the mechanical plant that serves our air conditioning systems, the kinds of lighting and the way we control that lighting in our buildings, the way we use hot water and we source hot water, as well as renewable energy. We've got a really comprehensive solar PV program that helps us to not only reduce our energy usage, but also generate revenue for the university every year. So whilst energy is a really key part of our carbon mitigation strategy, because it just is so much of our carbon footprint, we're also focused on the other areas that make up our carbon footprint. For example, we installed some of Queensland's first electric vehicle fast chargers to help encourage the uptake of electric vehicles. We do a lot of work around encouraging sustainable transport options. And we also have planted over 25,000 trees across our campuses in the last 3 or 4 years to help sequester carbon and restore native vegetation. In everything we do to reduce our energy usage and our carbon footprint, we're particularly interested in trialling and demonstrating innovative technologies such as solar, emerging developments in solar PV. An example of this is our Gatton campus solar farm. It's the largest solar research station of its kind in the Southern Hemisphere and one of the largest solar farms in Australia currently. It comprises over 37,000 solar panels covering around about 11.5 hectares and it's 3.3 megawatts in capacity in total. And at this solar farm, we're trialling three different technologies: fixed panels, single axis tracking and dual axis tracking. And the idea of this is to demonstrate and learn from the experiences of the different tracking technologies to look at how much energy do they generate, is the cost benefit of this technology worth it, do they present any unique maintenance and operational challenges, and to use the findings of this research to not only reduce our campus carbon footprint, but also to then teach industry and others who might be looking to build similar large-scale solar farms. UQ's commitment to carbon and energy reduction is really paying dividends for the organisation. Over the last 5 years, for example, our carbon footprint has reduced by 14%, and this decline is continuing. Our energy usage in 2016 is down 5% on our energy usage at the same time in 2015. And this is paying not only good reductions in terms of our emissions footprint, but also our financial returns. So this is saving us around about $1.5 to $2 million per year, and there's a return on investment for the organisation of around 30%. So we want to continue rolling out these energy efficiency measures, always looking for new areas of opportunity and new technologies and techniques that we can implement. What we're really finding though with an organisation that's large and complex is that it's not one silver bullet that will reduce your carbon footprint, and in fact it's many small changes and many small opportunities that add up to make a big difference. One of the particular areas that we're interested in focusing on is reducing the energy intensity of our laboratory spaces. Laboratories, due to the nature of the heating and cooling and the other equipment that they require within them, are really energy intensive. So we want to spend some time looking at what is best practice and what is some of the new and emerging techniques we can use to reduce energy intensity of these research spaces. We also want to continue with a rollout of renewable energy. We're currently one of Australia's largest generators of renewable energy, and we want to continue being one of the largest generators of renewable energy in Australia. In fact, we're looking at opportunities such as taking our Heron Island Research Station completely off-grid and demonstrating that small, isolated communities such as the Heron Island Research Station are able to be powered purely with renewable energy and energy storage technology like batteries.
Green buildings, large-scale renewable energy trials, and comprehensive energy efficiency and behaviour change programs. These are some of the ways UQ is pursuing global leadership in carbon management.